Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India online class biology session ultrastructure of cell. So we have discussed about the history of cell science, that is Robert Brown discovered the nucleus and Robert Hooke was the first person to study the cell and introduce the term cell, and the cell science was begin in 1665. The cell theory was put forward in the 19th century by Sladen and Schwann. We studied about the size of the cell and the shape of the cell, and the structure of the cell. We discussed about the plasma membrane, cytoplasm, and we discussed about the nucleus to some extent, not total. So let us proceed further about the structure of nucleus, the cell organelles. What are cell organelles? The small structures which are present in the cytoplasm of the cell, which perform different functions of the cell. How can you define a cell? A cell is the basic structural and functional unit of all living organisms. So nucleus, it was discovered by Robert Brown, and we discussed general structure. It is the most prominent organelle, okay, and it is present in the center of the cell. It consists of nuclear envelope, nucleolus, nuclear pore, and chromatin material. So let us study each and every structure of the nucleus. The nucleus of an eukaryotic cell. We are discussing about the eukaryotic nucleus. The nucleus of a eukaryotic cell is covered by a double-layered nuclear envelope or nuclear membrane. So this nuclear membrane, the nucleus is covered by means of a nuclear membrane, and it is made up of two layers. In between the two layers, perinuclear space is present. There is a space between the two membranes that is called perinuclear space. Next, the nuclear membrane possesses small openings like this. There are several openings are present. So these openings are called nuclear pores. They are called nuclear pores. The openings are present, and around each opening on the outside a small annulus is present. Okay. Around these small annulus is present. The Hammerling, that is the scientist, okay, the name of the scientist is Hammerling. Hammerling proved that nucleus is the seat of heredity. It is the seat of heredity through grafting experiments on acetabularia. So Hammerling, he conducted experiments on the largest algae, that is acetabularia. Okay, and he conducted which experiments? Grafting experiments on this acetabularia algae. And he proved that the nucleus is the seat of heredity. Heredity means the chromatin material which is present in the nucleus. The chromatin material which is present in the nucleus is made up of the DNA and the chromosomes. So that's why it is he considered the nucleus as the seat of heredity. Next, in the nucleus, nucleoplasm. What is nucleoplasm? Nucleoplasm, the nucleoplasm is the fluid present inside the nucleus. The fluid which is present, this is the nucleoplasm. Nucleus is filled with the nucleoplasm. Below the nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm is present. In this, several chemical substances like glycoproteins, RNA and enzymes are present. Then chromatin network, this green colored part surrounding the nucleoplasm. So it is called the chromatin material or chromatin network. In the nuclear spore, many chromosomes are present. They are thin and filamentous. They are in the form of a network. Network means net, twisted threads will be present, no? Like that. They are in the form of a network. On the chromosomes, genes are present. These genes are called the units of heredity. For example, this is the chromatin network. Like this, thread-like structures. So this chromatin network, when it is during cell division, it breaks into chromosome. Let us consider it as a chromosome. So this is a chromosome. Let us assume this is a chromosome. So on the chromosome, these units are present, like the small structures are present. Each chromosome may contain hundreds of these units. They are called genes. What are genes means? Genes are the vehicles of heredity. They carry the characteristics from parents to offsprings, children. Okay, that's why the chromatin material is very, very important. The nucleus in the functions we will discuss. Let us proceed. This chromatin material is divided into heterochromatin and euchromatin. So this is the chromatin material, thread-like structures, we are calling it as DNA. So this DNA is the actual vehicle of heredity. Okay, it is present in the genes. So this chromatin, ultra-microscopic structure we are discussing. Inside the nucleus, what is there? We are discussing. Okay, euchromatin and heterochromatin. In the interphase, actually what is interphase means? During cell division, at the time of cell division, the total chromatin material will undergo some changes. In the beginning or before cell division, that resting period, it is called as interphase. Actually, it is not the resting period, during which the interphase is the phase between the two cell divisions. Okay? So this interphase, where the cell prepares or get ready for cell division. It gets ready for the cell division. During which what happens means, the chromatin material gets doubled, or the duplication of the nuclear material, chromatin, takes place, because the cell division after the offsprings or the daughter cells which are formed can also possess the same number of chromosomes as that of the parent. That's why this takes place, interphase. In the interphase, nucleus and chromatin network shows dark stained regions. They are called heterochromatin regions. See here in this picture, dark stain region means thick color. So nucleolus will give that color. Okay, nucleolus is the part of the nucleus which impart color to the chromosomes. Nothing but this chromatin material. The dark stained region in this inside the nucleus, it is called heterochromatin, and the light stained region, it is called euchromatin. U means true, which contain DNA. Euchromatin contains DNA. Okay, next. So actually in 1928, Hedge defined heterochromatin as condensed chromatin part. Okay, chromatin material get condensed during cell division, during interphase. Before that it was diffuse, free, and at the time of cell division, when the cell starts decided to divide, then the chromatin material gets condensed. It was said by Hertz in 1928, heterochromatin as condensed chromatin part. Okay, the human cell nucleus only this is. In the human cell, the outer nuclear membrane is there, and the inside, the chromatin divides into two parts, heterochromatin and euchromatin. Heterochromatin is the chromatin material which is stained, bright colored, and the euchromatin which is present in the center, that is light colored, and it is a true chromatin. Okay, so let us proceed. Nucleolus. In the nucleoplasm, one or two round structures are present. They are called nucleoli. Nucleoli means plural. Nucleolus means singular. They contain proteins and DNA, and they produce ribosomes. Ribosomes are produced from nucleolus of the cell. The functions of nucleus, if you take, nucleus plays a major role in the general metabolism of the cell, and it is helpful in the synthesis of ribosomes. It is also helpful in the synthesis of RNA. It controls and synthesis of proteins. It is the seat of heredity due to the presence of DNA. DNA is the genetic material. In it, the cell nucleus functions as the intermediary of heredity. Cell nucleus functions as the intermediary of heredity. Means without nucleus, no hereditary material will transfer from the parent cell to the daughter cell. Okay? And this nucleus controls almost all vital, very important functions of the cell. Hence, the nucleus is also called the control center of the cell. It is considered as the control center of the cell, or often it is called cell brain. Cell brain. Okay, children, let us proceed to the next. The types of nucleus. There, depending upon the number, size, and nature of nucleus, the cells may be of following kinds. Okay, on what basis? On the number of nucleus, the size of the nucleus, and the nature of the nucleus, the cells can may be divided into the following kinds. Eukaryons. Eukaryons means it is a cell which contain a single nucleus. U means true. Karyon, nucleus. Single nucleus, if it is present, such type of cells are called eukaryon. Or the nucleus present, only one nucleus is present, then it is called a eukaryon. Dikaryon. Karyon means the scientific term for the nucleus. Karyon is nothing but a nucleus. Dikaryon. Dikaryon means if the cells contain two nuclei of same kind, then it is called dikaryotic cell. Okay. Next, polykaryon. Poly means many. It is a cell that contains a number of nuclei. Nuclei means plural. Nucleus means singular. So if a cell contain more number of nuclei, then it is called a perikaryon or polykaryon type. Next, heterokaryon. Till now we come across only containing the same kind of nucleus. Eukaryon, dikaryon, polykaryon. In eukaryon with single nucleus. Dikaryon with two nucleus of same kind. Polykaryon, number of nuclei of same type. But heterokaryon means, hetero means different. Okay? Heterokaryon. It is a single cells which contain nuclei of two types. Produced by fusion of two cells. So such cells are called heterokaryotypic cells. Synkaryon, another one. What is a synkaryon? It is a hybrid cell. It is a hybrid cell line generated by a heterokaryon whose nuclei have entered mitosis synchronously and merged. Merged means together. Means or a karyon is formed by the fusion of two nuclei. It is called a synkaryon. Okay? A nucleus formed by the fusion of two different. It is the product of heterokaryon fusion. Okay, children. Till now, what are the different types of nuclei? Just name. Eukaryon, dikaryon, polykaryon, heterokaryon. Okay? And final one is synkaryon. Next, another type of classification. Depending on the nature of nucleus, the nucleus itself may be of different types, following types. Amphinucleus, amphi. It is a diploid type of nucleus and it contains two sets of genomes, means two sets of chromosomes. And in somatic cells it is found. Okay, these are all the terms you have to remember. Okay, somatic. What is somatic? Means vegetative cells. Other than spermatozoa and ova, the remaining cells of the body are called as somatic cells. Or vegetative cells. Whereas the cells produced from the reproductive organs, they are called germ cells or reproductive cells. Okay? The hereditary material which is present in the germ cells only will be carried to the next generation. Okay? The fusion of gametes takes place and where the exchange of nuclear material takes place. And the new characters are produced, or the characters of the parents will be shared to the offsprings. So here somatic cells. Amphinucleus means it is a diploid. Diploid means, diploid represents the number of chromosomes present in the cell. Okay, you will study in the higher classes. So let us assume, if a cell contain n number of chromosomes, means one set, 2n. 2N means diploid. Okay. Genome means genes. Okay. Next, heminucleus. Heminucleus means it is a haploid type of nucleus and it contains only one set of genome. Heminucleus type of nucleus is found in the gametes. Okay, heminucleus is a haploid type of nucleus and it contains only one set of chromosomes, so it is present in the gametes. Heminucleus is present in the gametes. Diploid means 2n, haploid means 1n, only one set of chromosomes. Pronucleus, it is a haploid nucleus of an ovum or spermatozoon present in a fertilized ovum before their fusion. It is called pronucleus. The nucleus of an ovum, before it unites with that of the spermatozoon, which has penetrated, it is called female pronucleus. The pronucleus is of how many types? Two types. Female pronucleus and male pronucleus. Male pronucleus represents the spermatozoon. Female pronucleus represents the ovum. Okay? So, zygotic nucleus means by the fusion of male and female nucleus it is formed. The nucleus of the spermatozoon, after it has penetrated as ovum, an ovum, is called the male pronucleus. The nucleus of the spermatozoon, after it has penetrated an ovum, means reach the egg cell or ovum, then it is called male pronucleus. Okay? So, depending on its nature, and the nucleus itself may be of the following types. Once again, micronucleus and macronucleus. Here, the last one, fourth type. Okay, previously we studied different pronucleus. Okay, male pronucleus, female pronucleus. Okay, we also studied the different nuclei. Depending upon the nature of the nucleus itself, the types of nucleus, eukaryon, dikaryon, polykaryon, heterokaryon, and synkaryon. And depending on the nature, the nucleus itself may be of following types. We studied about the amphinucleus, means diploid type of nucleus. Heminucleus, it is a haploid type of nucleus present in the gametes. Pronucleus, pronucleus is present in the gametes. Once again, before that spermatozoon penetrates into the ovum, okay, and after penetrating the nucleus of the spermatozoon, after it penetrate the ovum, it is called as male pronucleus. Okay, male pronucleus and female pronucleus, okay, they combine to form the synkaryon. Okay, it is a hybrid cell. Okay, zygote, or it is also called. Then now the micronucleus and macronucleus. So it is a fourth type. The first type is amphinucleus, second type is heminucleus, third type is pronucleus. Depending on its nature, the nucleus itself may be divided into four types. What are they? Amphinucleus, heminucleus, pronucleus, and micro and macronucleus. In a dikaryon, means a cell with a dikaryotic cell which contain two types of nucleus. The two nuclei are unequal. Okay, they are of different size. So among these, the smaller one is the micronucleus and the bigger one is the meganucleus or macronucleus. For example, what is this animal, children? What is this structure? This is a paramecium. A paramecium is a unicellular organism, protozoan, eukaryotic cell it is. It possesses two nuclei inside. It's a dikaryotic cell. One is the large one, it is called macronucleus or meganucleus, and the smaller one is called as a micronucleus. These two nuclei perform different functions. That is, the macronucleus performs vegetative functions, means digestion, respiration, excretion, like that. And the micronucleus performs the reproductive function. Okay, that is binary fission. So during the conjugation is the sexual reproduction in this paramecium. During that conjugation, those pronucleus are formed. Pronuclei. Male pronucleus, female pronucleus. Okay. So this is about the nucleus. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to receive latest updates.